Hey, morning, James.
How you doing, man?
Oh, I'm all right. I'm pretty exhausted.
Oh, you're tired?
Yeah.
Get much sleep?
I didn't get a whole lot of sleep last night. I got like 2 hours.
Oh, man. Sleep's important, dude. Here, let me show you why.
All right. We're here with Kevin Robel, men's volleyball and, among other sports, athletic trainer. Talk about sleep deprivation and sports performance in athletes here at Stanford. Hey, Kevin. How's it going?
Good. How are you?
Good. You do deal with athletes in helping them rehabilitate after an injury. How would a lack of sleep affect their ability to get back on the court as quickly as possible?
There's this lack of neuromuscular control, proprioception's kind of decreased. Sometimes they'll have trouble remembering or wanting to remember certain steps in their treatment or rehabilitation or which exercises they have to do, kind of doesn't make for a quality session.
Now, many students here at Stanford, not even athletes, do have a problem with sleep deprivation, and athletes in particular do, and just because of their study schedule and their athletic schedule. And obviously the best way to overcome a short night of sleep would be a nap, but you see many people also using caffeine or other stimulants to help overcome their sleep deprivation. What kind of suggestions could you make for a student like that? Or is a nap the best way? Or if you can't at all take a nap during the day because of your schedule, what would you suggest?
I don't think I have to tell this particular population that those things don't help. They can only exacerbate the problems.
Mm-hmm.
There is some compelling research out that's, you know, probably the number one most commonly used stimulant is caffeine.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think there's some compelling research to suggest that has inflammatory properties. So someone that's battling chronic injury or coming off an injury in general, caffeine can slow down the recovery process as far as inflammation goes and pro-inflammatory cells. Things that, if they absolutely cannot have a nap, I have other suggestions. You know, I can't really underestimate the importance of the diet. You know, there's in the presence of lack of sleep, the body has to work harder, and it needs that energy and that fuel to work harder. So if you're, you know, I wouldn't know the relationship, but I would guess that someone that's having trouble getting a normal amount of sleep but is really concentrated on a healthy balanced diet will do better than someone that doesn't, you know.
And as far as sports injuries go, do you think an athlete's more likely to have a sports injury if they are sleep deprived?
I'm sure, as you probably have learned in your class, you know, sleep is when we tend to heal
mm-hmm.
ourselves. So if you're constantly working at a deficit, you know, basically you're working uphill every day if you're dealing with a chronic injury, you know, because you don't get the opportunity for your body to heal that area.
All right, I'm here with strength and conditioning coach Taylor Lynn. She's the coach for men's volleyball as well as women's volleyball and other sports. I'm going to talk to her about sports performance and sleep deprivation in athletes here at Stanford. How's it going, Taylor?
Good, how are you?
Good. So first I want to talk about you see a lot of athletes come into the training room every day. How many do you think have some sleep deprivation when they come to perform?
Honestly, I would say the majority. That's one thing I've noticed, kind of the Stanford culture, is a lot of the student athletes stay up late and sleep in late. I think that has a lot to do with just the workload that you guys have to go through. So I would say, honestly, the majority of student athletes are. I feel like sleep is the number one recovery tool. Your nervous nervous system's always overactivated. And, I mean, being on your computers and watching TV before bed doesn't help at all. But there are some breathing activities that we've spoken about to the team that will just kind of help relax you. Some light reading, listening to relaxing music is very helpful. But ultimately, avoiding as much as possible staring at your computer screen, that would help for sure. You need a period where you can kind of slow everything down before you go to bed. But the more that we work on our sleep patterns, I would say, it ultimately just gives you a little edge on our competitors. So.
Hey, morning, James.
How you doing, man?
Oh, I'm all right. I'm pretty exhausted.